Okay, this video is going to be about solving word problems that require more than one step for their solution. And before we get going, let me just say one thing about word problems. I know that most students don't like word problems, and I believe part of that is because they don't get enough of them. They don't do enough of them, and so if you don't do many of them, they seem like they're hard. So ultimately, I guess my advice is do as many word problems as you can. Look for word problems in your book. If you have done all the word problems in your book, ask your teacher if he or she can give you more word problems. The more you do, the easier they'll become. They may at some point even become enjoyable. But even if they don't become enjoyable, at least they'll probably become easier. Okay, so let's do one. So this problem says, the width of a rectangle is 7 feet more than 1/3 of the length. If the width is 22, what is the length? Okay, so it looks like we're comparing the width and the length. So let me start out with a W and an L so I can compare the width and the length. And it says the width is 7 feet more than 1/3 of the length. So I think the first thing I want to do is figure out what 1/3 of the length would be. So if L is the length, 1/3 of the length would be the length divided by 3, or L over 3. And it says the width is 7 feet more than that, than the length over 3. So if it's 7 feet more, it means I would have to add 7 to 1/3 of the length in order to get the width. So now I've got my equation. I've got a width equals L over 3, 1/3 of the length, plus 7. And my problem also tells me that the width is 22. So instead of W, I'm going to put in a 22. So 22 equals L over 3 plus 7. And now all I've got is this one variable, the L. So I should be able to isolate that. Well, the first thing I want to do usually in a problem like this is start with the addition or subtraction part, which means let's get rid of that 7. So I'll subtract 7 from both sides. 22 minus 7 is 15. On the right side, I'm just going to have L over 3. The 7s will cancel because I have plus 7 minus 7. So now I've got 15 equals L over 3. I want to get the L by itself, so I'll multiply both sides of the equation by 3. So 3 times 15 is 45. And these 3s will cancel. And I get that the length is 45. So let's go see if that works. If the length was 45, remember my equation said that the width was the length divided by 3 plus 7. And now my question is, if I put a 45 in, I'm sorry, if I put a 22 in for the width and a 45 for the length, will this balance? So 22 equals 45 divided by 3 is 15. 15 plus 7 is 22. So my equation balances, and my answer will be that the length is 45 feet. Here's another one. When Maria and Nicole went shopping, they both spent exactly the same amount. Maria bought 3 t-shirts and a $9 belt, and Nicole bought a sweatshirt for $16.50 and 2 t-shirts. How much did each t-shirt cost? Okay, so let's take a look. Maria, we'll just get our information down here. Maria bought 2 t-shirts and she also spent $9. So the cost for Maria was 2 times the cost of a t-shirt plus $9. Nicole bought, let's see, I'm sorry, Maria bought 3 t-shirts have to get our information right. Nicole bought two t-shirts, and she also spent $16.50. Now, what we know is that Maria and Nicole spent the same amount of money. So if this is the amount of money that Maria spent, 3t plus 9, and this is the amount of money that Nicole spent, 2t plus $16.50, then these two numbers, these two amounts, must be equal because Maria and Nicole spent the same amount. So let's make an equation where we say that 3t plus 9 is equal to 2t plus 16.50. We want to get the t's on one side and the 16.50 on another. I'm going to, I think, subtract 9 from both sides. So now I've got 3t equals 2t plus, let's see, 16.50 minus 9. Let's do 16 minus 9 is 7, and I still have that 50 cents, 7.50. And now I still want to get the t's by themselves, so I'll subtract 2t from both sides. 3t minus 2t is just going to give me t. And these 2t minus 2t cancels, and I get 7.50. So the cost of a t-shirt is $7.50. Let's go back and check that. Okay, so three t-shirts plus $9, that would equal 3 times 7.50 plus 9. 3 times 7.50 is $22.50. And $22.50 plus 9, so 22 plus 9 would be 31, plus the 50 cents. And 2t plus 16.50, the amount that Nicole paid, so that's 2 times 7.50 plus 16.50, running out of room. 2 times 7.50 is 15. 15 and 16.50 is 31.50. So both these amounts are the same, which is good because we wanted to make sure that Michelle and Nicole spent the same amount of money. So that means our answer is correct. The t-shirts cost $7.50 each. Okay, that's it. Once again, the more of these you do, the better you'll be at them. After a while, like I said, you may actually get to enjoy them. If not, you'll at least do better on your tests. Okay, take care. See you next time.